All right, we're talking tonight about Edward Bernays, and it is important. This is part of education. If you want to really understand how to empower yourself and be able to create, you have to understand what's really going on in our society, and you have to start at education. The problems that we have now in our society, a lot of people will say, I mean, this is the story of stuff, that we are focusing on stuff and things, and we're killing the planet, and we've got to recycle. We have to do these things. I told you that Edward Bernays also believes that people are animals. They really only go with one of these four things here: self-preservation, aggression, security, sex. So, his solution, if you want to control people, well, you have to control everything. Bernays had a daughter. Her name is Anne. She was videotaped in a BBC documentary, The Century of Self. It's unbelievable. She explains this way.
Democracy, to my father, was a wonderful concept, but I don't think he felt that all those publics out there had reliable judgment, and that they very easily might vote for the wrong man or want the wrong thing, so that they had to be guided from above. Enlightened despotism, in a sense.
Enlightened despotism.
You appeal to their desires and their unrecognized longings, that sort of thing. That you can tap into their deepest desires or their deepest fears and use that to your own purposes.
Okay. That doesn't sound... Enlightened despotism is not the government of the people, by the people, and for the people. So what did he do with it? Bernays, remember, he started as a journalist, and he was a big fan of Walter Lippmann's work. Lippmann was a major political writer and thinker of the time. He always thought of the people as the bewildered herd. Again, so people are animals. This one's just a bewildered herd. If people were only animals controlled by sex, aggression, self-preservation, well, how could we control them? How do we know that they won't rise up? If people can't control themselves, if they're not rational human beings, then the fundamentals of our country are all wrong. The Declaration of Independence is wrong. This is the progressive era when they thought the founders were wrong. Bernays and Lippmann looked at our government not as a way of ruling by the people, but as a way to control the people. Just people who couldn't control themselves because they're a bewildered herd, they're animals. Bernays wrote in his book, Propaganda, this one. He wrote, "Our leaders must be a leadership democracy, administered by the intelligent minority who know how to regiment and guide the masses." Well, that leaves with the question, who is the intelligent minority? Who knows how to do that? Wow, they're going to regiment and guide the masses. We use the intelligent minority all the time these days. You go to the top. You go Andy Stern, Richard Trumka. We use them to spread the message to the unions. The NEA can use art to get their agenda across. They fund Media Matters. They'll tell people what to think. It's the Wizard of Oz and the Matrix and Star Wars all wrapped up in one. You have to look behind the curtain, take the red pill, and realize they're just trying to use the dark side of the force. And it's not just in politics, it's everywhere. For the past few years, we have been lamenting about America being a consumer culture, right? We've been saying it. You got to get out of debt. Buy what you need. Make smart choices. It's not new. Why are we such consumers? In the 1930s, businesses worried about people stopped buying their goods. So a Wall Street banker who worked for Lehman Brothers wrote, "We must shift America from a needs to a desires culture." Well, people need to be trained to desire, to want new things even before they've consumed the old thing. Man's desires must overshadow his needs. That was the start of our disposable economy. Dixie cups. Bernays, a client of Bernays. When they hired him, he formed another committee for the study and promotion of sanitary dispensing of food and drink. One ad featured a woman saying, "Have your cups. Have them in individual Dixie cups. Be more exclusive. Be more than exclusive." Quote, "Be safe." Bernays is the one that made our society disposable. But that's not all. Not done yet. Next. Last night's funeral or memorial service had T-shirts with a slogan. It was marketed, and it bothered me. I don't know if it bothered you. I thought the president did a great job, but the marketing of it bothered me. It was a memorial service, a national tragedy. Public relations, nudge, behavioral psychology, I don't know, but it is moving people. Here, look, this is where it always runs into trouble. We told you about Edward Bernays and the philosophy in the early 20th century of the progressives was that people are animals and they really only operate on four things: self-preservation, security, aggression, and sex. That's it. Underlying, people are not good, they're not smart. Underlying that is this: it's an animal. And if you don't control them, they'll act as a herd. So the elite need to come up and orchestrate and move the herd. Now it's called Cass Sunstein's nudge. But it started with Edward Bernays. And here's where it goes wrong. When you have the elite looking over a herd, they can become very arrogant. Here is Bernays' own daughter and how she described her father.
People who worked for him were stupid, and children were stupid, and if people did things in a way that he didn't, that he wouldn't have done them, they were stupid. It was a word that he used over and over and over. Dope and stupid.
Okay. See if you've...
And the masses?
They were stupid.
Okay. The masses are stupid. People are stupid. You don't understand. They're stupid. Cass Sunstein, we've shown you this, has said pretty much the same thing. Watch.
Once we know that people are human and have some Homer Simpson in them, then there's a lot that can be done to manipulate them.
Got it. So they're stupid, so we can manipulate them. The problem is the thinning of the herd, because when stupid people just don't get it, anger. Because don't you know? It's just about self-preservation. We've got to do these things. You people are just too stupid. And once in a while, you will see one of the, if I may use Bernays, one of the animal spirits coming out in one of the elites that are there to guide the herd. This is new video from Governor Ed Rendell. Watch.
Losing money.
Let me answer this. I've known you for two or three decades. You're a very smart person.
But not now.
But you're not getting
it. I'm dumb now.
You're not getting it. Those people would lose that money anyway. Don't you understand?
Our pressing him on this point led to this.
You guys don't get that.
I do get it.
You're simpletons. You're idiots if you don't get that.
I think I particularly like the clenched teeth. Simpletons, idiots, who need to be collectively gathered and told what to do. Who's pushing this agenda, this idea, for instance, to action for the jobless in mass is Frances Fox Piven. Watch this. Earlier this month, she wrote, quote, "Before people can mobilize for collective action, a herd, they have to develop a proud and angry identity. A psychological transformation has to take place. The out of the work have to stop blaming themselves and turn their anger on their bosses, the bureaucrats, or the politicians who are in fact responsible." Whether it is coming from Cass Sunstein, Ed Rendell, or Frances Fox Piven, this is not a new idea, and it all comes from Bernays. So when they talk about somebody who is coming up and planning and plotting violence, this is why I'm against Frances Fox Piven, because she's sowing the seeds. Get together as a collective, a herd, and seize your anger, your aggression. It's Bernays. And until you learn history, we will stand by and repeat it and not know why we're doing it. Back in a minute. Tonight, we've been trying to tell you a little bit about Edward Bernays, the father of spin for the hour, because you need to understand how you're taught what to think, but not to think. How Edward Bernays, the power of persuasion, was used for positive things. It was. He helped the plight of African Americans. He was instrumental in getting Calvin Coolidge elected into office. A good thing. But there is danger. It is danger. It's a powerful tool. It can be used for good or evil. It depends on who's holding the key. And when government, science, and media are involved, there is trouble on the horizon. The left may think they're using Saul Alinsky tactics, but really it stems from Bernays. It's the instinct of aggression. This is why I think E2 education. Education is so important. It's why I tell you, please, do not take my word for this. Do your own homework. I don't want you to believe anything I say. I'm not asking for your trust. Do your own homework. I'm trying to make you curious about things. Allowing one man, even me, to tell you your views or what you should like or dislike, that's propaganda. This is not. This is education. Watch the documentary, The Century of Self, or read Brené's books. Read propaganda. It will blow your mind. You can go to glennbeck.com for more information. But make up your own mind and think for yourself. Question things like bacon and eggs. Where did they come from for the first time? Find out the answer. Think for yourself. That is empowerment. And the truth has no agenda. I have to tell you, last night I went to Spider-Man here in New York City the second time. It is the eighth wonder of the world. And I go backstage, and I meet Julie Taymor, and this is Bono. We spent about 30 minutes last night. I'm not a fan, generally, of Bono. What a nice guy. Read about it at glennbeck.com. See you tomorrow. Amazing show tomorrow night from New York. Good night, America.